Hello. This is odd and something new because we're gonna do a bump date. Mainly because I like the name bump date, and if you know anything about me, I need to act on fun names like the mom group that we created called Perk and Play because I wanted a reason to hang out with moms and drink coffee.
Like the only reason Perk and Play exists is
Yeah.
because you like the name.
So
So thought of this bump date, and now you're gonna get bump dates.
we have to go live and give a bump date. And those of you who can't figure it out, I am pregnant, and bump comes from
Are you really gonna explain
a
this?
bump, and update comes from anyway. So
If you have to explain it, it kind of loses the impact.
that is one reason why this random thing is happening. And the other reasons are because we just kind of want to.
Based off the last 5 minutes of just setting this up and starting, it should be pretty entertaining. I had to peel her off of the couch to do it sitting up instead of laying down.
There's a good chance that I was going to be laying down during this, because
Which
that's
would
real
have been
life.
fine.
That's real life.
It's allowed.
It's a bump date right
She's a
there.
big fan of this couch, so it'd been appropriate.
Also, if you know me, I hate this couch. But I'm a big fan of documenting my life in the form of blogging. Those who don't know, I enjoy writing and posting the inner workings of my brain to
Should we
the
introduce ourselves?
World Wide Web. My name is Laura.
I am Dr. Andrew Root from my Thrive Tribe Chiropractic People, and this is the one and only Laura.
I just said that.
Well, I wanted to introduce you fancy
That
and
was
special.
super annoying.
I don't know how well the mic transferred on the MacBook computer here, but that was
Stop
a
it.
drum roll
Anyway,
for the amazing,
you're
beautiful.
annoying me. You're annoying me.
So where were we? So,
I enjoy documenting, and
yes.
Facebook and all of the social medias like to remind you couple years down the road of things that you've documented, and so it'll be kind of fun to relive these
Oh,
days.
it'll be something.
It'll be fun.
But
And
there's real reasons that we want to push play and share too.
yes, and also because we do things a little differently in our world. People think we're a little weird and a little nuts sometimes, but especially when it comes to the birth world. With our first child, we have a 21-month-old.
Introduce them.
You can't see him. He's hiding in pillows
He's sleeping.
for now.
Hopefully.
But we do things weird, and with him, we experienced a home birth, and it was a really great experience for me. I really enjoyed it. So we are prepping for another home birth, and that really freaks people out because it's really unknown and not super common, and there's a lot of, I don't know. Stigma, the right word?
There's a lot of misunderstandings, I think
Yes.
you could say.
About home birth, just because there's not a lot of.
A lot of unnecessary fear or
Yes.
apprehension.
So I get a lot of questions and just concerns and wonderings, comments. So being that I've experienced it and I'm preparing for another one, and I've since enjoyed blogging, I started after my son was born. I thought this might be a fun way to also document the preparation of a home birth and kind of help
Yeah.
people walk through it with us if you're interested
I
in
feel
it.
like the birth photographers, we've got some amazing birth photographers in the area, but those images are what people would gravitate towards. But really where home birth comes from is the 6 to 9 months leading up to the home birth and getting ready and preparing and making it happen. So that's what we want to do, is share that journey with everyone else, whether that's our Thrive Tribe, whether that's our friends and family, whether that's anyone in the birthing world, mama world, natural community that could benefit from it.
So let's get to the bump date.
So here we are. So this title here, Bump Date Week 13. Reality is, this is week one of the bump dates, but week 13 of pregnancy. So confusing, but necessary, because if bump date one was anything but bump date, week 13, it would probably be not rated PG and not for small children viewing, because we're just getting out of the tail end of Laura being slightly less cranky than an angry gorilla.
Only slightly.
Anyways, first trimester Laura, as if anyone who's read the blog recently about that phase of life, is not her favorite time. It's just tired.
But it
a
is
lot.
His favorite time.
It's not my favorite time either. A lot of tired, a lot of, we'll say, not a lot of patience.
Basically,
maybe is a mild
anything,
way to put that.
Anything he said or did just really ticked me off. It was just so annoying. It was so annoying.
I don't
even have specific examples because
there are none. If you gave examples, everyone here would take my side.
I doubt that.
Because it's ridiculous.
I doubt that. So I'll just recap the first trimester since you didn't get to live it with me. So
you don't want to.
Just as I was feeling, you know, the typical nauseous, exhausted, just lack of energy. I really hated coffee, which was really sad for me. I love just a special drink, and I didn't get my special drink.
The same special drink every single time. A tall iced coffee.
One pump vanilla.
With a little bit of vanilla and a little bit of room for cream.
Just
a splish.
Just a splish of cream. And I did not like coffee. Didn't want anything to do with it. This pregnancy, I experienced some weird, weird dreams.
Oh.
There was some crazy nights. I did not get a lot of sleep. The one night really freaked me out.
I literally woke up to her jumping out of bed and crashing into the wall and like knocking the blinds over.
Because I had this dream that there was a boa constrictor coming up our feet and it was going to kill us. So I jumped out of bed and I was like convinced that this was real. It was weird. So I didn't get a lot of sleep because I was having such vivid dreams that did not happen with Zeke. And like we had already touched, I was cranky and mad all the time. And where some women get really emotional, like crying emotional, I got really emotional in frustrated lack of patience. I didn't want anything to do with anybody. And so that might have something to do with this time having a toddler and just my patience is already thin because heat's
true.
Test my patience. I don't know. So those were my feelings during first trimester. Our prep work for a home birth was pretty chill. I mean, whether you do a home birth or a traditional hospital birth, the first trimester is pretty slow moving as far as what to do to prep for a birth. So because we birthed in Illinois the first time, we had to kind of start all over with people that we want to use for our birth team. So we had already had an idea of the birth team we wanted as far as the midwives that we wanted to be here.
Steel City Midwives.
So we
Natalie and Karen
went with Steel City Midwives. Just what?
Do you know some of they're starting an apprenticeship program? Remember we talked to them about it? Caitlin Kish is going to be one of the apprentices. Lily, one of the doulas I met with. Congrats,
nice.
Caitlin and Lily.
That is so exciting.
Might have one of you guys at a birth.
Maybe you'll see me naked. That'd be fun.
Maybe you'll see her naked, I guess.
It'd be a little weird.
Anyways.
That's what happens at a birth.
One of the many things that happens at a birth. So yeah, Steel City Midwives. Really excited about them.
And yeah, so we had to, you know, go through the whole hiring process, meet with them, look at the contract, whatever. And then we had our first midwife appointment. And that happened 11 weeks. It was later than it did with Zeke
recently.
Because second baby, not really in a rush because we kind of knew how it went.
Yeah.
And knowing that we weren't going to have an ultrasound, we couldn't hear the heartbeat until later anyway because they use a handheld Doppler instead of an ultrasound. So the later you wait for the appointment, the more likely you can hear the heartbeat. And so they came to our house, and which was awesome because our midwife in Illinois
literally laying on this couch.
Our midwife in Illinois, we had to travel like 45 minutes to an hour every time we wanted to have an appointment because she traveled all over the city. So we had to go to her office, and it was a lot. It took a lot of time, and that was exhausting. And so it was great with having a toddler. We didn't have to wrangle him in a doctor's office, and they came to our house. They brought everything in their big packs. And if you've done this before, if you've had a baby, you know that prenatal visits are pretty standard. You show up, they weigh you,
pee in a cup,
they test your urine. I always pee on myself because I don't know how to not. I don't understand. So I'm going to pee on myself for once a month for the next forever long. So,
and then every other week. So and then every week.
That'll be really fun.
Maybe you can just get better at it.
Didn't last time. So they take your blood pressure, and technically they didn't weigh me because they assume everyone has a scale, which we do, but it's broken and unreliable. So I need to get a new scale.
Gets cracked around.
Sometimes it hurts my feelings and sometimes it makes me feel really good. So
depending on how you shift the scale, you can do really good. You can lose a few pounds, gain a few pounds.
So I should have a little more reliable of a scale. So I need to get that. But then, midwives it's a little bit different than going to an OB office because instead of having like a 20-minute visit, you have an hour-long visit where they touch on everything. They talk to you just about your stress level, your home life, your physical activities, your...
Take bigger picture into consideration.
Yeah.
They want to know the whole situation.
Ask how you're feeling, what you're eating. I told them about my weird dreams and they... added magnesium as a supplement that it's in my prenatal, but I wasn't taking extra. And so they were thinking I was a little deficient in magnesium. And
most of us probably are. Take your magnesium. Just ordered some more for the office today so we can hook you up.
Yeah, so I started taking it and my sleep improved dramatically. Not having weird dreams anymore.
I'm a little disappointed in that part.
Sleeping more soundly. So that's great. Also not having weird like leg cramps and stuff.
Yeah, any restless leg stuff, any sleep stuff, just anytime you'd calm down, make sure that you got enough magnesium.
Yeah.
A pro tip.
So they just talk to you for a really long time, touch base, get to know you as people because they're gonna be in your house. And then
they're gonna see you naked.
See you naked. And then they brought out the Doppler and they warned us. They said, this is still kind of early. Usually with the handheld Doppler, they expect more like 12 to 14 weeks to be able to hear the heartbeat. So they put the cold jelly on my belly and Zeke wanted it on his. He kept
belly. Looking at her and lifting up his shirt. And...
He didn't understand. And so.
That was fun.
Yeah, they searched for a little while, kept reassuring me, like, don't panic, it's still early.
You can tell they deal with crazy pregnant ladies all the time. So it was lots of reassurance.
Yeah. Thankfully, I mean, this was not the first time and I knew what the Doppler did, so I wasn't worried. But they did end up finding the heartbeat, which was fun. It was a fast little thing.
Supposed to be.
Yeah. Should we tell them the wives?
Oh, like, you think it's girl or boy?
Yeah.
They say, like, there's two things, right?
Yeah.
If it's a little, like, there's always a range of what's normal. If it's more on that upper range, they say the old, you know, old wives tell or old myths are, it's more likely to be a girl. And if you're on the left side of mom's belly, when you get a good reading, I guess, when you pick up the signal for the heart rate, then that's also kind of like a check in the female box.
So they said if baby's playing their game, their old wives' tale game, then they would say it's a girl.
And if that's the case, send it back. What's the return policy?
I'm hoping for boys.
Yeah, I mean.
There's only one emotional mama allowed in this house, and that is me.
We'd be all right being all boy parents, because I think two sets of female emotions in like 10 to 15 years from now, it's gonna be too much. by about two.
But obviously we will love it.
Yes.
Or what. We will
and you
be.
Always do say you love that. You love seeing me with a little girl.
I would love to see him with a little girl. And let's be honest, little girl clothes are way cuter than little boy clothes.
That's the problem, actually. We got boy. We got lots of boy clothes.
Yeah.
We got way too much Target nearby to have a girl.
So, anyway.
We talked about misconceptions earlier. Let's back up and share a midwife one.
Okay.
Because a lot of people might have any idea how that process works at all, for like how much it costs. Because usually you just think, oh, I don't really think about that. I just go to the hospital, show my insurance, and things work out. One, home birth costs drastically less than a hospital birth will. So that's a big step in the right direction. Still, City Midwives has all of their costs and fees and everything like that on their website. So I'm not like sharing any private information. The global fee, which means that everything from when we first met them through multiple postpartum care visits, is $3,800, right? So just under $4,000, where hospital births are going to top out at way, way, way more than that. And it's covered by insurance, so as well. Like we have one of those health sharing networks, so not technically an insurance, but a sharing network, and talk to them. They'll pay everything just like normal insurance cover would. So common misconception is that would be finances are a reason for, you know, not wanting a home birth or something like that, but not the case. It's actually way cheaper.
Obviously, check with your insurance of what they cover, but yes, it's covered, and we're thankful for that.
Yeah. Also, isn't this a cool shirt?
I have one that matches. It doesn't fit me right now.
Yeah, it would. You,
I have to.
She thinks she's like a ginormous whale.
Well, let's get to right now. So that was prep work for first trimester. That was recap for first trimester. Right now, this is a bump date for week 13. So let's get to week 13.
Here we are.
Here we are. I feel better, as in.
Thank goodness.
As in, I have more energy and I'm not as nauseous. Sometimes I still get nauseous, but it's not nearly as bad. I have been wanting coffee more recently. But because I haven't drank it, caffeine now makes me crazy. It, like, so I have to be careful.
You need smaller doses.
Yes. And what else have I been feeling? Oh, I have noticed that it's easy for me to get headaches. If I don't drink enough water, or if there's like an imbalance of what I'm eating, if I'm not getting enough protein or enough carbs or whatever, my body notices it way more. And way more drastically than
it, gotta make a baby.
Yeah, than it had when I wasn't pregnant, or even I didn't notice it this drastically with Zeke when I was pregnant before. But if I'm, especially with water, I get pretty bad headaches if I don't drink enough water. But then when I get headaches, I get nauseous, and then I don't actually want to consume anything because I'm nauseous. So I just need an IV of water to solve that. So that's one thing that I have to, like, stay on top of, because it's really easy to forget whenever you're chasing a toddler around or just not carrying a water bottle with you all the time. So I always, when I pack my diaper bag, I always have snacks for Zeke, snacks for mom, water for Zeke, and water for mom. Because now...
A very needy family.
Yes. So that's kind of been a weird challenge. Because I've been having more energy, I've been able to work out more. So the first trimester, it was hard for me to get to the gym because I didn't have the energy. And when I would go to the gym, it would drain me even more so. And it was really hard to keep up during the day. I would be totally depleted of energy. So I cut back a lot and realized it was probably better for my body because my body was telling me it's not a good idea to totally deplete yourself. So I'm excited because I have more energy and I can kind of get back into that. So I've been doing more walks, jogging, and
had a PR squat clean this week, yesterday, right?
Wait, yes.
For you non-CrossFit lingo people, squat clean is when your bar is on the ground and you pick it up, catch it in the front rack, would go down then to a full squat and stand it up the way. And 13 weeks prego, she did more weight than she's ever done before. So, boom, high five. Hot stuff, this one.
Stop it. stop it right now.
So, which we probably mentioned, she won't be having a PR squat clean 3-6 months from now. Mm-hmm. You need to taper and change exercise as you go through pregnancy. But right now, CrossFit, fine. Keep it up. Keep moving. Modify. Adapt things. Don't push yourself to the limit. Don't redline. Don't go all out in the same way. But paced workouts are great. EMOMs, which is like an every minute on the minute. So some sort of workout with a built-in rest would be great, because you can still stay active. You can still challenge yourself. Still stay fit and strong and healthy, so you can keep up with your kiddos throughout pregnancy. You can stay healthy throughout pregnancy and have a great recovery. Keep doing CrossFit. Near the end, the last 2 to 3 months, we'll probably back off that even more, do a lot more functional movements and progressions, a lot more prenatal yoga, which is amazing for during pregnancy. Gets your breathing right, gets your positioning right for different labor positions. So all fantastic stuff. I'm sure you're going to be hearing about on future bump dates. Anyways.
That's exercise. How else have I been feeling? Oh, I've been feeling chubby.
Yeah.
I'm in this weird stage of starting to get a belly. It doesn't go away when I suck it in. It's still there. Baby is the size of a small peach this week. Andrew loves the fruit comparisons. It's his favorite.
I learned a new fruit through this. What was the one weird
kumquat.
One?
Kumquat.
I had never heard of a kumquat.
I tried to buy one at the grocery store. They don't sell kumquats.
It's because they don't exist.
So this week is a small peach.
Please comment on this wherever you're watching it if you've heard of a kumquat before or if you think it's made up.
K-U-M-Q-U-A-T. Kumquat.
I can spell made up words too.
Anyway. So I'm sort of getting a belly now. So my regular clothes aren't comfortable, but my maternity clothes don't fit yet. I don't have a belly to like hold up the maternity pants, and the shirts are just baggy. So I'm in this really awkward stage of not being comfortable in any of my clothes, and it's kind of awful. There's a 100% chance right now that my pants are unbuttoned while I'm sitting here because I was just sick of wearing them. At least they're on, but.
I walked in the kitchen earlier and she's like, I don't know, I think cleaning up from dinner. And I'm like, why are your pants undone?
It's hard. So that's the, like, second trimester is the sweet spot, but. It's also this really awkward time where strangers are like, she's just getting a little chubby or something going on.
I don't think anyone can notice yet.
Maybe not, but like it's getting to
no
that
one
point.
Can notice near as much as you feel like
well,
it is.
Yes. Well, because you feel like a whale already because there's something in you pushing on everything. So that's how I feel during the week 13. Prepping is just more of like reading. Resources.
Oh, I got a resource here.
We got a new resource.
This is, I got it a while. I got it a year ago, but we haven't read it.
I mean new as in it was not out yet when I was pregnant last time. So this is,
really?
Yeah, it came out when we had him, after we had him. So we got it, but.
Gonna fact check that.
But didn't.
2017.
Had him in November 2016.
All right, carry on.
Yes. So. I'm reading this resource, Mama Natural, as I'm going through this pregnancy. There are a couple others that I want to reread, but I'll probably wait until I'm a little closer to birth because it's a lot of like getting your mind into labor. And
which ones would you reread?
Birth Partner. And
thought she was going to say that.
I'd read some of Ina May's birth stories.
Ina May is awesome and also real out there. If you think we're weird.
It's real.
No one, ignore that. She's reading comments here. It's unrelated. Ina May is like the mother of midwifery, the spearhead that started a big birthing movement recently here in the last, I don't know, 50 years ago. She's, if you've seen a birth documentary ever, she was probably in it as like the hippie looking lady. She's got some really cool stuff. And what's her book called? don't remember. I think it's just Guide to Natural Child, the anime Guide to Natural Childbirth. But we both really, you've read more of this than I have, right?
I think so.
I've maybe read, like, because it's organized in weeks. Mm-hmm. Like, this is week one, week two, week three. I've probably made it through week six or seven, and I think you might be closer to that. But we both really love the introduction, and seriously, it would be worth getting that book just to read the introduction.
Yeah, I'm actually wondering if there's a way we can just get the introduction.
Let's call Miss Genevieve Howland.
Article or something, because the introduction is just really good to explain, not necessarily home birth, but why natural birth. People are passionate about it.
Why should you consider having one? Yeah. Basically, what's the advantage? Like, why would you go through the extra work, the extra effort? The not taking, you know, the epidural routes or anything like that. Why the heck would anyone ever choose to do that? She really does a good job of explaining why, both from a physical perspective for mom and baby, as well as a mental, emotional, social perspective of just what that means for mom to accomplish that.
And for the science people, like, there's science and statistics and whatever in there. So it's just, puts a lot of what I am passionate about into words that are hard to explain or say in the moment. So love the introduction. If you're ever at a bookstore, just pick it up and read the introduction. If you're ever just wondering, you don't have to buy the whole book. I mean, she probably wouldn't like me telling you not to buy the book. Buy the whole book. It's fine. That's my prep work right now as far as resources that I'm reading. I'll read like blogs or whatever that come across that the midwives post or whatever, but that's the main book that I'm reading right now. I get weekly adjustments by this guy because my body's changing and I always get weekly adjustments, but now
every prenatal mom deserves prenatal chiropractic care. Firmly believer in that.
But now I'm actually sometimes getting more than weekly adjustments because
she's attitude adjustment.
Like the other day, I needed to do some stuff at the office, but I was super uncomfortable. I couldn't breathe. My hips just hurt. And I was like, I can't, you need to adjust me first because I won't be able to focus on anything because this is really uncomfortable. And so he adjusted me. I could immediately breathe better. I wasn't uncomfortable sitting or felt like I had to keep trying to take deep breaths. That's been an issue with me this pregnancy is I already feel like I can't breathe. And so
it's gonna be fun.
Yeah. So that has been major, staying active, and I need to schedule another prenatal massage. I had one prenatal massage.
If any of our massage therapists, prenatal massage therapists, community partners are listening, let's figure something out. Got a good one for you.
Well, the ideal is to get pretty regular prenatal massages because things hurt and are moving and are tightening and loosening and shifting. So this, in the coming weeks, I need to schedule one of those. We need to get our blood panel.
Yep.
Because that still happens whenever you're...
Do all the normal blood work, make sure everything's on track, there's nothing weird happening.
And I am trying to be okay with napping when Zeke naps and not feeling guilty for not cleaning the house or whatever, because the reality is your body needs to chill out sometimes. So it's okay to relax. So the other day I was feeling extra. The first trimester I napped all the time when Zeke was napping. But the other day, even though I had more energy, I was feeling really wiped that day. And so I didn't even try to do anything. I just said, you're going to nap, I'm going to nap. And we both took a nap.
And you slept through grocery pickup.
I did. And then I locked myself out of the house.
Oh, yeah.
With my kid. So, okay. If anybody has heard of, well, most grocery stores have something like this now where you can order your food online.
Curbside pickup.
For Giant Eagle. You order your food online and then you go at a certain time and pick it up, like a half hour window. And I've noticed that I actually save money when I do that. Like,
it costs
drastically.
$3 or $4 to do it.
Yeah. I think four or five.
Best investment.
Because
time and money you get back.
Because I would easily overspend by like $40 plus each visit.
Close. 10x return on investment.
So it's actually saved us money. And so I woke up and
And
there
you
was
don't have to
like,
drag the toddler through the grocery
yes,
store.
we woke up from nap and there was like 7 minutes left in my time slot. So I just grabbed a snack for Zeke because I knew he'd be hungry in the car. Didn't put pants on him, no shoes, nothing. It's hot as all heck outside, and booked it outside. Locked ourselves out of the house, locked the door without grabbing the keys. Thankfully, we live right across the street from the office, so I actually had my phone in my wallet. So I called him at the office, and he so graciously, happily, with a smile on his face, came over to the house and
I was gone for maybe 3 minutes, so we made it
yes,
work.
that helped.
Would
The
be
patients were very
a
kind.
much bigger problem typically. Well, it was someone was pulling up as I was
Yes.
leaving, so it wasn't I didn't like leave people here. Let's not be crazy.
Sorry.
I would have sent Alyssa.
So, yeah, that was pregnancy brain, Laura brain, toddler mom brain. It kind of all just goes together right now. I don't know who I am. So yeah,
Life.
that's kind of where we're at. He's still kind of annoying me all the time, but I think that's marriage too.
Innocent.
And not just pregnancy.
Completely innocent.
So we'll see how that continues. Maybe I'll like you again.
I'm not holding out hope.
Yeah, so if you have any questions about home birth
Yeah, let
or
us know.
whatever.
We'll I'm sure as we go on there, we'll kind of cover some different topics, different weeks. Maybe I'm kind of picking this up off the top of my head right now, but maybe prenatal vitamins, maybe more on my exercise. Talk about chiropractic care more, although I think everyone hears enough about that. I
I
don't
know
know.
I do.
Maybe we'll flip through some of the Mama Natural stuff and share some of the topics that she shares. Lots of good stuff. But let us know if you've got any ideas, and we'd be happy to share.
Okay, well, to future Andrew and Laura, I hope that you enjoy your new baby. This is
Do
for
you
when
want
Facebook like reminds us that we did this. Hope your baby is great.
to? What about the dog vomit?
Oh, our dog is kind of sick right now.
He's okay.
He's kind of sick right now and keeps throwing up. But
He's
Andrew
thrown
thinks
up a
that
couple
I should
times.
clean up the vomit because he put the baby down. But I don't think I should because I'm growing a baby and that's way harder. So.
I was. What was. Okay, I went upstairs to change. To get ready to lay with Zeke to put him down, and in the process of that, I saw a spot in our bedroom that he had just thrown up in. And this is like not nasty throw up, it's just a little bit of greenish foam, like a tiny little spot. That's all he does. And I came back downstairs, and I had Zeke with me, so I couldn't clean it up because he would want to play in it. So I just kind of covered it up, moved on. I came down, I'm going to put him to bed. I said, "Hey, can you take care of the throw up that I found up there?" While I'm laying with him,
And we
and
got
she
in a little
thinks.
argument because I said, I should not do that. I am pregnant. And he said, I should not do that. I am putting Zeke down.
I was busy. She had the next, 45 minutes to herself. I
I
don't want
clean
to
I
ask. Did
cleaned
you?
up more throw up down here.
So you didn't clean up the upstairs
Well,
stuff?
I didn't want to go up and mess up bed time.
Oh my gosh.
So we have life under control here. It's fine.
So there's still throw up there.
Better go to it. Okay, well, have a great night, everyone.
See you later.
See you next week.